What is the amount of subsidy which is available under the scheme? 15% of the cost of eligible plant and machinery, or rupees 15 lakhs, whichever is less, is being provided by way of subsidy by the Government of India. The only thing which needs to be ensured is that the unit has not availed a loan of more than 100 lakhs. That means about a crore of rupees. Less than that, if the unit is availing, the subsidy is available to the unit. The subsidy is available to the existing as well as newly registered SSI units. Subsidy is available for replacement of existing equipment, and while calculating the subsidy, it will be with reference to the purchase price of plant and machinery and not connected with the loan amount which is sanctioned. One more initiative which has been taken for developing the small scale industries is establishing a credit guarantee fund trust. Now, this was established in July 2000. This institution provides the guarantee to the banker for providing collateral free advances to the extent of 1 crore of rupees. The condition is that a banker should not insist for any security and or a guarantee while sanctioning the loan. The guarantee which is available to the banker is quite substantial. For loans up to 5 lakhs, the cover is 85%. And the different segments, according to the amount of loan which has been sanctioned, that we are going to see in the next slide. But of course, to avail of this guarantee, the borrower will have to pay a one-time guarantee fee and an annual service fee as prescribed by the Credit Guarantee Trust. So, what is that guarantee provided by CGST MSE is, according to the different categories and the amount which is sanctioned, is available in this PowerPoint presentation, the maximum guarantee which is permissible under the scheme. Say up to 5 lakhs for micro enterprises, the guarantee which is available is 85% of the amount in default, subject to a maximum of 4.25 lakhs of rupees. So the banker is well covered. If the exposure is 5 lakhs, the guarantee trust will give you 4.25 lakhs by way of guarantee to you, and amount will be reimbursed to you. And if it is more than 5 lakhs but up to 5 lakhs, the cover is up to 75%. The maximum amount is 37.50 lakhs. Above 50 lakhs and up to 1 crore, the amount will be, the ceiling for giving the cover is only 62.50 lakhs. For women entrepreneurs, other than the credit facility up to 5 lakhs for micro enterprises as stated above, the cover is 80% of the amount in default, subject to a maximum of 40 lakhs of rupees. So this is a good avenue for the banker to ensure and encourage small scale industries that even if a small scale industry says that I don't have any security to offer or I can't offer you a guarantee, please help me. Well, this can be suggested to that unit that yes, we'll grant, but we'll be definitely taking a cover provided by CGT MSE. Of course, the fees will have to be borne by the borrower. Now, to help quite a good number of small establishment, they find it difficult to prepare a project report. To help all such units, the ministry has brought out project profiles in respect of in 8 volumes titled New Project for Small Entrepreneurs. These project reports, which have been published by the ministry, provide basic information, broad industry groups, market potential, quality control standards, implementation schedules, technical aspects, financial aspects including analysis, and address of machinery and equipment suppliers. What more do you want if you want to start an industry? Go through these reports and definitely it will be of help in starting an industry. Now, what are these things which are available as per the publications of the government? One is on chemical products, The second one is on food products. The third one is on electrical products, electronic products, mechanical products, glass and ceramic products, metallurgical products, leather and leather products. Quite a host of things have already been covered in these project reports, and they are priced very cheap, varying from basic 23 rupees to a maximum of 55 rupees. And these project reports are available with the Department of Publications at Delhi, and also they have got some outlets throughout the country. One can easily purchase this, understand, and the same project report which has been given, published by the ministry, also can be given to the banker. This is how I'm going to go about. So this is one good initiative which has been taken by the government of India. The other initiatives which have been initiated by the government is Credit Link Capital Subsidy Scheme for Technology Upgradation. This scheme was launched in 2000 and revised with effect from September 2005. It aims at facilitating technology upgradation for micro enterprises by providing 15% capital subsidy. We have already seen this. The next one is a guarantee scheme that we have discussed elaborately. The third one is getting an ISO certification. The fees paid for getting this certification is also being reimbursed by the government, and to the extent of 75% or maximum 75,000, the fees which are paid to the institution for getting certification are reimbursed. The another scheme which offers, if a unit is taking part in the exhibitions which are conducted overseas, the funding by the government is up to 75% in respect to to and fro airfare for participation in trade fairs, etc., outside the country. One more, creating a scheme of microfinance program. It's creating self-employment opportunities, and definitely it is going to help the country in eradicating the poverty. In conclusion, SME sector is the backbone of the economy, especially in a developing country like ours. What is required is the coming together of the government agencies, regulators, and much more than that, the financing agencies as well. Banks have to view lending to SME as a profitable venture rather than taking it as an avenue for forced lending. And more importantly, the paradigm shift in the lending operations of the bank to SME sector is to be discerned and managed pragmatically and proactively. Once we take these initiatives, definitely it is going to provide a lot of employment opportunities to our youth, and it will definitely add to the GDP of our country. Thank you very much.